With Evangelist Renee Sellers on the Prayer Line, Monday through Friday, beginning at 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. and 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. Monday through Friday, with devotion, prayer, and pronouncement of daily affirmations. Set the atmosphere for your day. Say what you want to see. Dial 1-712-770-4010 using access code 266-590. That's 1-712-770-4010 using access code 266-590. Set the atmosphere for your day. Say what you want to see on the Prayer Line with Evangelist Renee Sellers.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. This is Evangelist Renee Sellers of the Upper Room Outreach Ministries in Waycross, Georgia, and we are live at 5 this morning on this Think About It Thursday morning. These days are going by so fast, you got to think about what day it is. To God be the glory. This is another day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. This is another day that we're excited to be on WHLJ 97.5 FM. 103.3 FM, 1400 AM, Statenville, Valdosta, Moultrie, Georgia. You can also join us online at Foxy, F-O-X-Y, 97.com, and you can join us on the call at 712-770-4010, access code 266-590. There'll be a recap tonight at 7 p.m. As we continue our study on the seven churches in Asia Minor in the book of Revelation. We are in Revelation chapters 2 and 3. Revelation chapters 2 and 3. We're talking about our subject today is be faithful unto death. Can I say that again? Be faithful unto death. Be faithful all the way until the end. Don't walk away. Don't look away. Don't turn your back on God. Be faithful unto death. We're going to talk about the letter to the church at Smyrna. We talked about Ephesus yesterday, and now we're going to still take a journey along the Aegean Sea in the, near the Mediterranean, which is what is now Turkey. We're going to take a little journey about 50 miles northwest of Ephesus to a city by the name of Smyrna. But before we begin, I am going to ask Pastor Gloria Moore Wright to open our broadcast with a word of prayer.
Gracious Heavenly Father, hallowed be thy name. Lord God, you are worthy of glory. You're worthy of praise. There is none like thee. In your presence is fullness of joy. In your presence is peace forevermore. And this is what we desire, to be one with you. We thank you for the open heaven and the fresh anointing. We thank you for stirring up the very gifts in us right now, Lord God, that we can come together from the north, the south, the east, and the west, together in your name, giving you glory, praise, and honor. We thank you for the Upper Room Outreach Ministries, Pastor Samuel, Evangelist Renee Sellers, for bringing forth Command Your Morning Prayer Line on Foxy 97.5 FM. We thank you for another day's journey, Lord God, just to say, Lord, you're worthy of glory, you're worthy of praise. We ask that you open up our spiritual mind, ears, and hearts to receive thy word this day, that it may be planted upon good ground to come up into fruition as you call it to be. Open up our spiritual minds and hearts right now, Lord God. Heavenly Father, that we still serve you and worship and praise thy name. For thine, O Lord, you are the greatness and the power, the victory and the majesty, for all that is in heaven and earth is thine. Thine is the kingdom, O Lord, and thou art exalted as head above all. We know no other help but thee. We thank you for all that you've done and what you're yet to do. In the matchless name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen.
Hallelujah. In the matchless name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. I'm telling you, 1 second in Radio Land is like 10 minutes. We thank God. I called on Pastor Wright, but I meant to call on Evangelist Griffin. So thank you so much, Evangelist Griffin. Let's take a journey to Revelation chapter 2, verses 8 through 11. Revelation chapter 2, verse 8 through 11 this morning. I truly believe we are right on the brink. We are at in the last days. We know we're in the last days with everything that is going on. If it's not evident to you now, come on, somebody. If it's not evident to you now that we are truly in the last days, we've been talking about this since I was a little girl, but I believe that we are here, ladies and gentlemen, and it's time for us not to be scared, but to be prepared. Can I get somebody to help me say it's not the time to be scared, but this is the time to be prepared, because what is coming in the future is not something that we want to be a part of. There's some things that are coming in the future, and what Christ is doing it with the seven churches is really not only giving them, commending them for certain areas, but warning them so that they can be prepared for what's coming. And so as we go through these seven churches in Asia Minor, this is an opportunity for us to be prepared, not caught off guard, not caught off focus. Ladies and gentlemen, this is not a time for fear. This is a time to walk by faith, not by sight. This is not a time for fear. This is a time for us to truly be about our Father's business. This is not a time for fear. This is time to occupy until he comes. Revelation chapter 2, verses 8 through 11 reads, "And unto the angel of the church in Smyrna write, these things saith the first and the last, which was dead and is alive. I know thy works, and tribulation, and poverty, but thou art rich." If you could stick a pen or a highlighter, if you're writing your Bibles, underline or highlight, "I know thy works, and tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are of the synagogue of Satan. Fear none of these things which thou shalt suffer." I want you to underline or highlight, "Fear none of these things." "Fear none of these things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Underline or highlight 10 days. Underline or highlight 10 days. "Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life." Underline or highlight crown of life. "He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. He that overcometh shall not be hurt of the second death." I need somebody to give God praise, because we truly are overcomers. Let me go back a little bit. "I know thy works," commendation to the church at Smyrna. "I know thy works and tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are of the synagogue of Satan. Fear none of these things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life. He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. He that overcometh should not be hurt of the second death." Subject once again is coming from the verse that says, "Be faithful unto death." Be faithful unto death, all the way to the end. Whether you're caught up to be with the Lord when Jesus comes for the church, or you fall asleep, be faithful unto death. This city is located about 50 miles northeast of Ephesus, along what is the Aegean Sea right now. Smyrna was a very rich and beautiful commercial city, and it was recognized by Rome as its loyal ally and a center of emperor worship. The city is now called Izmir, which is located in what we call today's Turkey. Smyrna was a large port city known for great agriculture and appreciation for its beauty. And when you would look from a distance at the city of Smyrna, it would look like a crown resting on a hill. If you really picture that in your mind, a crown resting on a hill, that's what the city of Smyrna looked like at that time. In the 6th century B.C., before Christ, the city was destroyed by the king of Lydia, but once again it was rebuilt in 290 B.C. In his message to the church, the Lord again commended them for their good works. Jesus says in Revelation to John, in Revelation 2:9, "I know your works, your tribulation and poverty. I know your works. We got to understand that these were believers who were persecuted, and a lot of times they lost their means of livelihood because of their faithfulness in Jesus Christ, because of their commitment to the Lord. They were persecuted, and there's going to come a time in the future, and I know a lot of times we think that there won't be any believers, people won't be able to be saved during the tribulation period, which that's the time when many of us, we won't have to deal with the tribulation, but there is going to be a time during the tribulation that believers will still have an opportunity to be saved, but in the midst of that, there will be great persecution against Christians, even in the tribulation. Ladies and gentlemen, I encourage you to be ready when Jesus cracks that sky and comes for the church. I know a lot of people don't believe in what we call the rapture of the church, because the word rapture is not in there, but the concept is in 1 Thessalonians 4. I believe, according to Scripture, that we true followers of Jesus Christ will not have to endure the 7 years tribulation, but there will be opportunity for people to be saved during the tribulation. I don't want to be him. I'm not going to be here to have to deal with that. But in the midst of this, while we are here, be faithful unto death, even when persecuted. Smyrna was persecuted because of their faith in Jesus Christ, because of their commitment to the Lord. And the tribulation of the church was a result of slander by those Jews, those other Jewish people in the community. And those people were advising the city officials, can I say government system, and I know that many times we feel like we're not supposed to take positions in government, but it was many times government that persecuted the church. And so it was these government officials that they advised the city officials to suppress the Christian movement, making a public confession of their faith in Smyrna. It meant that they would be hungry. It meant poverty. It meant they'd be thrown in prison. And at times, it meant that they would experience martyrdom, which meant death. I read somewhere that one of the leaders in the church was burned to death because of his faith. And many times the people in those times were burned to death. They were sewn asunder. They were crucified. One of the most agonizing forms of punishment. They were crucified, not because, you know, they just simply, you know, went to church and, you know, they dressed up, they looked good. You know, they were crucified. They were persecuted because of their faith in Jesus Christ. And many of them, listen, they were faithful until they breathed their last breath. In the time that we're living in right now, where we're faced with this storm that we're going through, with this virus going around, and many people's hearts are failing because of fear, I want to encourage you, ladies and gentlemen, to walk by faith and not by sight, and don't allow yourself to walk in fear. I know it can happen when you really constantly focus on the news and you constantly focus on what's happening, even with some of our family members. But ladies and gentlemen, I want you to shift your focus on the one who has overcome the world. And we are overcomers because of the price that Jesus paid. So when we look at the word tribulation, the Lord said, I know your works and I know your tribulation. In this text, this word paints a picture of a huge rock crushing whatever is beneath it. It paints a picture of a big rock crushing whatever is beneath it. Now you just imagine these people being crushed, and the pain that they're experiencing. Tribulation it represents excruciating pain that you experience. And what was happening is these people were facing intense and constant pressure because of what they believe. And I want to ask somebody this morning, can you identify with experiencing constant pressure and intense pressure because of what you believe? Because of what you believe. And, you know, and I know that we often face persecution because of what we believe now. Even with the government, you know, your 501c3 can be taken away if you preach certain things, if you preach against certain things like homosexuality, and if you preach against certain things, they don't want to strip you of your 501c3. And ladies and gentlemen, I believe that is a form of persecution when the government tries to tell us and tries to punish us for preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ and telling people what thus saith the Lord. But listen, can you handle being sown asunder? Yes, we'd be persecuted. And can we identify, even on a minimal level, what it means to be persecuted because of what you believe? There are some of us that have been persecuted by family members because of what we believe. How? Because when we were in the world, everybody was our friend. Everybody loved us. Everybody wanted to hang around us. We was everybody's buddy as long as we were going along with what everybody else was doing. But soon as we gave our lives to Jesus Christ, now they look at us and they say, you think you're better than everybody else. That's a form of persecution. You think you're better than everybody else. Now you preaching now for real? Oh, my goodness. And it's amazing how many people loved us more before we were saved than they did after we got saved. It's amazing how many people were on our side before Jesus than they were after we gave our lives to Jesus. For a moment in my own personal life, I used to think, like, wow, y'all wanted me to die and go to hell? Yeah, like, you don't, you know, be thankful and thank God that the woman of God and the man of God are saved now, and they don't have to worry about the ultimate final death, which is hell. And so, ladies and gentlemen, listen, can we identify with going through constant and intense pressure because of our faith? Many people are experiencing intense and constant pressure. But I want to encourage you this morning that God, just like he did not forget about Smyrna, and he did not forget about Ephesus. Why? How do we know he didn't forget about them? Because he chose to have John write letters to them. He chose to have John send a message to them, and that message was not only applicable for them, the message is applicable for us. So, ladies and gentlemen, even way back then, Jesus was thinking about us today. Isn't that some good news this morning, that even way back then, Jesus was thinking about us? Matter of fact, when he died, he was thinking about us. When he came, it was all about us. When he laid down his life, it was all about us. And so, ladies and gentlemen, Jesus is always thinking about you. He's always thinking about me. He has not forgotten you. Just like Jesus saw what they were going through, I want to encourage you that he sees and he knows what you are going through. Believers should not be surprised when their obedience leads to persecution. It shouldn't be a surprise when our obedience to God leads to persecution. It's amazing how Pastor Brown was arrested for having service, but then the next week they exempted the churches in that state. I thought it was like kind of funny. You arrest in 1 week and then you exempt ministries the next week. And so, ladies and gentlemen, don't be surprised that your obedience leads to persecution. The Bible says in 2 Timothy 3:12, all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. All that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. It doesn't say may suffer persecution. It doesn't say might suffer persecution. It says all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. But Jesus also says in John 15:20, he says the servant is not greater than his Lord. If they had persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they have kept my saying, they will keep yours. I want you to understand that the servant is not greater than his Lord. And if you're being persecuted, I would dare to say you're in a good place. Because watch this. Jesus has already identified with you. Now you can identify with him. In his message to the believers in Smyrna, Jesus commended them for being spiritually rich when he says in verse 9, but thou art rich. He said, you're poor, but thou art rich. Poverty, but thou art rich, which means that they were spiritually rich. These people knew how to draw on the deepest resources that the Lord had for them. They were drawing on his strength. to persevere during this time of persecution. They were drawing on his strength to endure during this time of great persecution. And I want to encourage you, ladies and gentlemen, during this time that we're going through right now, listen, whether it's persecution or sickness and disease, I want to encourage you to draw on God's strength so that you can continue to endure. Revelation 2 and 10, Jesus warned them that the devil shall cast some of you in prison that ye may be tried. I want to go back to something we said on earlier this week of how we can apply the messages of the seven churches. We can apply it to the churches as it was written back then. We can apply this message historically, and we can apply it corporately and individually. It can be applied to the churches as they were written back then. It can be applied historically because through the years, the church has gone through similar experiences as these seven churches in Asia Minor. We can apply the message corporately as members of the body of Christ, and we can also apply this message individually. And so Jesus warned them, the devil shall cast some of you into prison that ye may be tried. The meaning of these words to the church is that their situation was only going to get worse. They would have tribulation for 10 days, which may be referring to the fact that the early church suffered 10 major persecutions under the following leaders: Nero and Domitian and Trajan and Marcus Aurelius, Severus Maximus, Decius, Valerian, Aurelian, and Diocletian. There were also some persecutions in the local church which lasted 10 days. Let's take a note that in biblical prophecy, a day oftentimes means a year. In biblical prophecy, a day oftentimes means 1 year. And so how could these believers face persecution without fear with everything that was going on around them? How could they face persecution? How can we face tribulation and the problems that we are dealing with right now without fear? How can we do that? I posted on Facebook that stress weakens the immune system. And a lot of times people are stressed because they're afraid. People are stressed because of what they don't understand. People are stressed out and they're operating in fear because they don't know what's going to happen next. There are people that are operating in fear because, and this message in Smyrna is directed to believers, but I want to the church, to believers, but I want to encourage everybody that's listening this morning that no matter what you are facing and what you are dealing with, Jesus is the answer to your dilemma. Jesus is the answer to your dilemma. There are a lot of people that are facing fear because they don't know what's next. They don't know many people don't know where they're going to eat next because they've lost their job. How am I going to pay my rent when this thing is over because I'm not working anymore? I was already living from paycheck to paycheck. And matter of fact, one paycheck didn't even make it to the next paycheck. I was already struggling. So how is it that I can endure the next 3 or 4 months like this? So how can we face what we're going through, the problems and the persecution and the tribulation as they were experiencing? How can we face what we go through today? There are 3 keys that were given in this text that we can apply to our lives today. First of all, number one, we got to identify the real enemy. And I want to encourage, as the church at Smyrna was dealing with people and even the Jews in the city were creating problems, I want us to understand that the real enemy, the source of this issue was Satan. And I want to encourage you today that the source of what's going on in the atmosphere right now is Satan. Satan is always the source of sickness, disease, and any kind of evil. Satan is always the source. I want to encourage you, and I know that there is a tendency for some to blame God for what's happening right now. That there's a tendency to blame God for what's happening. Even in Job's case, in the book of Job, God was not the source. Satan was the source. Satan was the source of what was going on with Job. Even though God allowed the situation. He was not the source of the situation. So I don't want you to begin to blame God for what's happening, because he's not the source of evil. He's not the source of sickness and disease. Ladies and gentlemen, Satan is always the source. Revelation 2 and 10 reveals the real source of persecution and suffering is Satan. Fear not none of these things which thou shalt suffer. Satan is the real source. Recognize the real enemy. And one of the reasons that many of us cannot recognize the real enemy and cannot see past what is really going on is because, first of all, the gift of discerning of spirits and what's happening comes with a relationship with Christ. And so when we don't have that relationship, fear is inevitable. When we don't have that relationship, giving up is inevitable. I was in the store, the grocery store one day last week, and then the cashiers had on gloves and they had on a mask in their face, and I got to the cashier and she was like, "It's amazing how mean people are today." It's just, people are just so mean right now. And one of the reasons is because they're stressed out. There's a level of fear. People react when they have fear. They react in different ways, and most of the time negative ways, when there is fear. And so while people are operating in fear, the cashiers are having to take the punishment for it. Your spouse is having to deal with it. I heard the other day that domestic violence and child abuse at this moment has increased, and one of the reasons is because people are afraid. I want to encourage you, ladies and gentlemen, you don't have to be afraid. Listen, the thing you need to fear right now is God. Listen, God has not given us the spirit of fear, but you fear God. What I mean by fearing God, having reverence and submit all that you are to him right now. That is the one who is going to sustain you. He is the one who is going to cover you and take care of you in the midst of what you're going through and the things that you don't understand. We got to identify the real enemy. Don't blame God for your situation. And then secondly, don't be afraid. Like Jesus told them in Smyrna, fear none of these things which thou shalt suffer. We have to understand that fear paralyzes people. And it brings, it creates a mental bondage, ladies and gentlemen. It is a mental and emotional bondage. And we cannot be effective for God when we're operating in fear, which renders us powerless and ineffective. And so how could they not fear in the face of tribulation? They had to if you're going to operate in faith, then you got to put your face before God. We got to get in on our face and seek the face of God if we're going to truly operate in faith. Listen, because the conqueror of death, hell, and the grave was standing in the midst of the church with power, they can declare that they already had the victory. Revelation, the Bible says, he says, I am Alpha and Omega, the first and the last, which was dead and is alive. And ladies and gentlemen, Jesus said, be faithful unto death, and I will give you a crown of life. In the midst of whatever you're going through right now, joblessness, sickness, whatever it is, be faithful unto death. And this scripture says, I will give you the crown of life. Quick break for station ID. We're live at 5, talking about the church in Revelation chapter 2 at Smyrna. Our subject is be faithful unto death. Be faithful unto death. We're live at 5 on WHLJ 97.5 FM, 103.3 FM, 1400 AM, Statenville, Valdosta, Moultrie, Georgia. You can also join us online at Foxy, FOXY97.com, and you can join us on the call at 712-770-4010, access code 266-590. There'll be a recap tonight at 7 p.m. on WHLJ. I was looking at reading something, and I'm noticing, and it could just be me and where we are as people in the body of Christ. I'm noticing a lot of people that are members of the body of Christ are being affected by this illness that is going around the world. And I begin to feel strongly this morning in my spirit that because some people are seeing this, that they're beginning to question things as it relates to our Father. And once again, I want to encourage you, listen, remember that listen, don't blame God for this. God is listen, these attacks, we got to recognize the real enemy. Satan comes to steal, kill, and destroy, but we have to remember that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. No weapon forms against us their process. I know this is causing people to ask a lot of questions about your relationship with God. I want to encourage you to stay faithful. It's causing you to ask a lot of questions about, you know, if this is happening, you know, what is the point? I want to encourage you to stay faithful to God. Identify the real enemy. Do not fear. But Christ, listen, the message to us in the midst of our suffering, in the midst of persecution, in the midst of this test is to fear not. Fear none of these things. Fear none of these things, no matter what it is, sickness, disease, family issues, even if there's an issue concerning death. Do not fear, because God has not given us the spirit of fear, but a power, love, and a sound mind. So recognize the enemy, ladies, the real enemy. Do not fear. And then the third aspect is to remain faithful even in difficult times. Remain faithful. God told them at Smyrna to remain faithful, and if we remain faithful even unto death, we will receive a crown of life, and we will live forever. Well, listen, this is not even our home. If we're faithful unto death, we will receive a crown of life and live for eternity with the Lord. So shall we ever be with the Lord. That is where we should put our focus. A crown of life back then was a symbol of endurance and honor. And when you receive that crown of life, it is a symbol of endurance and honor. And this crown of life is waiting for all of us who finish this race with faithfulness, with endurance. And I want to encourage you to be like the Apostle Paul, as he said in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7. I want to encourage you today to fight the good fight. I want to encourage you to stay in the race. I want to encourage you to finish the race, because you got to stay in it if you're going to finish it. And then I want to encourage you to keep your faith in God intact. Fight the good fight. And there are some of you that are really in a battle for your life. I want to encourage you to fight. Paul is saying, listen, I fought the good fight. He said, I've done everything. I've finished the race. I have kept the faith. I want to encourage you right now to use this in the current, that fight the good fight. Stay in and finish the race and keep the faith. Keep faith. Be faithful unto death. In other words, don't lose heart. Don't faint. Don't give up. Don't get discouraged. Come on, somebody. Don't get discouraged. Don't let what you see going on around you cause you to just give up and fall down in depression. Don't do it. Fight the good fight. Stay in and finish the race. And keep the faith. Be faithful unto death. We've been in the book of Revelation chapter 2, talking about the church at Smyrna. I want to encourage you today. They were being persecuted because of their faith. I want to encourage you that no matter what it is, be faithful unto death. I am going to ask Pastor Gloria Moright to take us in with a word of prayer.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. O Heavenly Father, we bless you today, for you are a holy God. You are righteous. You are good all the time, and we say thank you today. We thank you, God, for looking beyond our faults and seeing our need, for loving us so much that you gave your son, Jesus, to die on the cross that we might have a right to the tree of life. And we say thank you. Thank you for salvation today. Thank you for the gift of the Holy Ghost. Thank you for being our help, O God, our protector and our protection, Father. You are our refuge, God, and we bless you today. Lord God, we thank you, hallelujah, for all things. We thank you, God, for the good and the bad. We thank you for the rough and the tough. If we never had a problem, we would know that you could solve them. But you're the same God that brought us out the last time. And we know that you can take us out, bring us out of this, Father. Lord God, we come today thanking you for Upper Room Ministries, thanking you, God, for Victorious Living Bible Institute, for Command Your Morning Prayer Line, Father. We thank you for WHOJ, Father. We pray blessings upon these ministries, God, in the name of Jesus. We ask, though, God, that you would continually bless Pastor Sellers and Dr. Renee Sellers. Father, we ask that you would restore the virtue that have gone out of her this morning, Father. We thank you for her diligence, God. We thank you for her studying, oh God, and for her imparting the word of God into the body of Christ. And we just bless you today. Lord God, we lift up all ministries that are represented on this call, and we thank you for each and every one of them. We pray blessings upon them, blessings upon their families, God, upon their homes, their finances, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, for how you continually make ways out of no way. We know, God, that if you bring us to a thing, you would take us through the thing. And so we just rest in you today. We wait patiently for you, God. Lord God, we pull down every doubt and every fear right now. But we know that you have not given us the spirit of fear, but of love and of power and of a sound mind. We thank you, God, for loving us so much that you have given us an opportunity to prepare ourselves, oh God, to take self-inventory, Lord God. And we pray, God, that you will help us to see ourselves as you see us. Lord God, we thank you, Father, for your compassions that fail not. We thank you for your mercies that are new every day. And we pray, God, that you would continually have mercy on us, continually have compassion on us, Father. Continually bless, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, we come today lifting up all those that are in need of prayer. Whatever that need is, God, we give it to you. For you said we can cast all of our cares upon you, for you care for us. And so, God, we give you our problems. We give you our struggles, God. We give you our trials, our tribulations, God. We give you doubts and fear, oh, God. We give you everything that comes to bring us down, that come to divide and conquer, that come to steal our joy, the thing that come to shake us, oh, God. For we know it's not your will to shake us, but it is your will to make us, God. And so we just yield to your will today, Father. We pray that your divine and perfect will be done in our lives, O God. Let your will be done on earth, even as it is in heaven. God, and we just thank you, hallelujah, and we just bless you today. We lift up all that are sick today, God, whatever the condition is. We take authority right now over every man of sickness, over every man of disease right now, God. And we ask, God, that you are blessed right now, Father. Lord God, we come against cancer. We come against AIDS. We come against diabetes, oh God. We come against high blood pressure, low blood pressure. We come against kidney disorders, oh God. We come against lung disorders, heart disorders, blood disorders. We come against arthritis today, Father. We come against eye disorders, oh God, ear disorders, Father. Heal today, God, one by one and name by name, Father, those that are suffering from this coronavirus, oh God. Lord God, we know, hallelujah, that it ain't this virus is just like a headache to you. There is nothing too hard for you, Father. And so, God, we give you all of our conditions, oh, God, all of our diagnoses, all of our prognosis, God, all of our symptoms, God. You never said we wouldn't have symptoms, but you did say, hallelujah, that Jesus was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities, and the chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes, hallelujah, we are healed. In the midst of the symptoms, we're healed. In the midst of the condition, we're healed. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. And we pray, God, that you will manifest that healing speedily, Father. Lord God, that it may be a testimony unto you, Father, in the name of Jesus. We pray, God, that you will go. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. into every hospital room, God, into the ICU units, oh God, those that are on respirators, Father. We pray that you will open up their lungs, oh God. Breathe through them right now, Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, regulate the oxygen, oh God. Regulate the vital signs, Father, in the name of Jesus. We speak to their bodies right now, and we put a command on them to be healed right now in the name of Jesus. Lord God, as they look up to you, Father, help them to elevate their faith, Father. And Lord God, hallelujah, thank you, God. We pray, oh God, hallelujah, that you would just be with them right now, Father, for we know that you already are. You promised never to leave us nor forsake us, oh God, and we just say thank you. We thank you, Lord God, for even if we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, thou art there. Lord God, hallelujah. We thank you, Lord God, for you are everywhere. You see everything, oh God, and we bless you today, Father. We thank you for letting nothing take us by surprise, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, for how you warn your people, oh God, so that they can be ready, Father. And I pray, God, that we all be ready in the name of Jesus. When your son Jesus come or call for us, God, help us to be ready, Father. When our time is out, Father, when we've gone the last mile of the way, Father. Lord God, when we've done all we can do down here, when we sung our last song, when we prayed our last prayer, God, I pray, hallelujah, that we all be ready, God. So I lift up every sinner everywhere, everyone that has not accepted Jesus as their Savior, all the unrighteous, the unholy, the ungrateful, the unthankful, God. Lord God, we lift them up before you right now, Father. We pray, God, that you will lead them and guide them in the midst of the fold, Father. Give them a mind to repent, God, a mind to cry out, Lord, have mercy. Hallelujah. A mind to receive the free gift of salvation, a mind to receive the gift of the Holy Ghost, Father. Lord God, we seek the Holy Ghost on every sinner right now, especially our unsaved loved ones, God. And we pray, God, that you will save, that you will sanctify, and that you will fill with the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Lord God, we thank you, hallelujah, for being our Jehovah Sikkenu, for being our righteousness, oh God. And your word said that the name of the Lord is a strong tower, and the righteous run into it, and they're safe, God. Lord God, when people are wondering what to do, oh God, where to turn to, oh God, let them turn to you, oh God. Hallelujah, thank you, God. Let them take advantage of the provisions that you've already made for us, oh God. And let them know, hallelujah, that we can all be safe in your arms at the same time, Father. We bless you today, God, and we give you glory. We give you honor, and we give you praise, Father. We lift up all those that are in harm's way, God. And we pray, God, hallelujah, that you will protect them, oh God, all those in the medical profession, Father, the hospital workers, oh God, the doctors, the nurses, the janitors, oh God, whatever their position is, Father, we lift them up before you right now, Father. And we pray, God, that you will cover them under the blood of Jesus. We pray that you will look on the police officers, the EMTs, God, the public workers, oh God, those that still have to go to work, oh God, those that are protecting the country, Father, those that are in harm's way, those that are on the front lines, oh God, protect them right now, one by one and name by name, Father. Lord God, keep them hedged in, keep them protected from all hurt, harm, and danger, Father. Lord God, as they sacrifice their lives, oh God, and as safety of their families, Father, we pray, God, that you shield them and seal them, Father, in the name of Jesus. And Lord God, we pray, oh God, that the provisions of equipment needed, oh God, will be provided, Father, and that it will show up right on time, Father. We pray that not another doctor, not another nurse, oh God, run out of supplies, oh God, but every one of their needs be met right now, Father, in the name of Jesus, so that they can still work the work, oh God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, of him that sent him, Father. We all have something to do, Father. We pray, God, that you will help us to do it with excellence, oh God, even while we're shut in, Father, even while we're on lockdown, oh God. Help us, oh God, to still occupy till you come, Father. Help us to be about our Father's business, oh God. Help us to call one another, text one another, encourage one another, build up, not tear down, Father. Help us to show faith and not doubt, oh God. Help us to show love and not hate, oh God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, hallelujah, we come against every ounce of unforgiveness, Father. Hallelujah, whoever is in, oh God. We come against sin in every form and fashion, God. We come against everything that comes to defile our tempers, oh God. Lord God, and we denounce, hallelujah, we denounce it right now, Father. We ask that you watch us today, God, that you purge us, oh God, that you purify our hearts, purify our thoughts, purify our minds, God. Let the mind of Christ be also in us, Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, we thank you today, oh God. We thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah, thank you, God. Thank you for saving us, God. Thank you for washing us. Thank you for blessing us, oh God. Thank you for sanctifying us, holy God. And help us, Lord God, to die daily to ourselves, oh God. For if we're full of ourselves, oh God, you can't fill us full of your spirit, God. And so, God, we empty out to you today, oh God. We empty out hatred today. We empty out malice and envy and jealousy and strife and bitterness right now, Father. And we pray, God, that you will fill us with your love, your peace, oh God, your kindness, oh God, temperance, oh God, self-control, Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. And, Lord God, as you baptize us in suffering, oh God, help us to be faithful unto death, for we know that you have a crown of life laid up for us, oh God. Hallelujah. And we thank you, Lord God, for that crown of life that's waiting for us, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, for giving us a mind to serve you in the beauty of holiness. We thank you for giving us a mind to live right, to walk right, to talk right, oh God, to be examples and role models, oh God, to let our light shine even now, God, so that others can see, hallelujah, our good works and glorify you, the Father, Father. Help us, Lord God, to not act unseemly in the grocery stores, in the supermarkets, oh God. Hallelujah, thank you, God. Help us to bridle our tongues, oh God. Hallelujah, not to fuss and cuss, oh God, over items in the store, God. Lord God, we thank you, Lord God. And we bless you, oh God, for giving us this time, oh God, to check ourselves before we wreck ourselves, oh God. Lord God, hallelujah, thank you, God. We repent, oh God, every time we messed up, oh God, every time we missed you, oh God, every time we got out of character, oh God, every time, Lord God, hallelujah, when we brought shame to the name of Christ, Father. Oh God, have mercy on us today, Father. Forgive us, Lord God, for our sins of omission, God, the things we could have, should have, would have done that we didn't do, oh God. And Lord God, forgive us of the things that we did do. We knew it was wrong, God, but we did it anyway, Father. We sin when we want to sin, God, but we repent of it right now, Father. Lord God, we thank you, Lord God, for being a compassionate God, a loving God, a kind God. But we know, God, hallelujah, as we look around, as we turn on the TV or the radio and we hear the news, oh God, we also know that you are God of judgment, oh God. Hallelujah, glory be to God. But we thank you, Lord God, and we thank Jesus for praying for us, oh God. And you said nothing shall by any means hurt us, oh God. And we just bless you today, Father. We thank you, Lord God, for protecting us, oh God, for shielding us and sealing us, oh God. We thank you for watching over us as we slumbered and slept, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, that 10,000 snares may tangle our feet, but none shall hold us fast. We thank you, Lord God, that none of these things shall come nigh our dwelling, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, for being covered under the blood, oh God. And you said, if I see the blood, I'll pass over you. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. We thank you, Lord God, for letting these plagues, oh God, and viruses pass over us, oh God. We give you glory today, God. We give you honor and we give you praise. Lord God, we lift up that one that's hard-headed, oh God, that one that won't be subject to the rules and the instructions, oh God, that one, oh God, that won't, hallelujah, quarantine themselves, that needs to be quarantined, oh God. We lift up those, oh God, that are walking around infected and don't know they're infected, oh God. That one, oh God, that's have the virus, oh God, and they're continually spreading it unknowingly, oh God.
And we pray, God, hallelujah, that you would touch them now and heal them miraculously, oh God. Oh Lord God, that they would seek professional help, oh God, in the name of Jesus. That is spread no further, Father. We come against this COVID-19. We come against this coronavirus right now, Father. And we pray, God, that you would eradicate it, Father. Stop it in its tracks, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Lord God, your word even said, except these days be shortened. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Lord God, hallelujah. Glory be to God. We thank you, Lord God, for you made provisions for us from the beginning of time, oh God. Hallelujah. We just bless you, God. We honor you, God. We praise you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. We thank you for your divine plan for us. We know that you know the thoughts that you think towards us, thoughts to prosper us and not to harm us, oh God, to give us an expected end, oh God, and that end is to be faithful unto death, oh God. So help us, oh God, hallelujah, to work the works, oh God, to finish our assignments, oh God, to do everything that you have assigned to our hands, oh God, to do, Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We thank you for your grace this morning, oh God, that's sufficient for us, oh God. Whatever we have to face, whatever we have to encounter, oh God, we know, oh God, that it's already all right, Father. We thank you that trouble don't last always, oh God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. For you are our bridge over trouble. Waters, oh God. You're our hope for tomorrow. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And because Jesus lives, hallelujah, we can face tomorrow. We thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Thank you, God, for this sacred season, oh God. Reminding us, oh God, of what you did for us, oh God. Reminding us of the provisions that have been made for us, oh God. And we thank you, Lord God, that Jesus wasn't left on the cross. We thank you, Lord God, that you didn't leave him in the ground. Hallelujah. Glory be to God, but on the third day he got up, oh God. And so God, we pray today, oh God, that you will help us to get up, oh God. Help us to get up out of our city, out of our pity parties, oh God. Help us to get up out of ourselves, oh God. Help us to get up out of our isms and our schisms, oh God. Help us to get up out of our complacency, oh God. Help us to get up out of our mediocrity, oh God. Help us to get up out of our hypocrisy, oh God. Help us to get up out of our doubt. Help us to get up out of our lack, oh God. Help us, oh God, to get up, oh God. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Lord God, in the name of Jesus, help your people to rise up. Hallelujah. Let our light shine, oh God. Hallelujah. In the dark times, oh God. Help us to be examples, oh God. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Help us to take our light out from under the bushels, oh God, and put it, hallelujah, oh God, on that hill, oh God, that we can be that hill, that city that can't be hid, oh God, in times like this, Father. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, we bless you today. We give you glory today. We honor you today, and we thank you, God. We pray all these blessings in the mighty name of your Son, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory
hallelujah
be to God.
To God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We thank God and we give God praise for the power of prayer this morning. We thank God that she tapped into what was needed for today, and we give God praise for it all. For the sake of time, I mean, she could have went in for quite some time, but we give God praise for Pastor Gloria Moore Wright and her commitment to this radio ministry of Command Your Morning. So right now, ladies and gentlemen, if there is one, two, three, four, anybody that is listening to this broadcast and you've heard the message this morning, be faithful unto death. The way to receive not only the blessings of God, but the benefits and the blessings of being a child of God, you must be born again. You must receive Jesus as Savior and Lord of your life. It is crucial now that we get to know Jesus like never before. Jesus and allow him to fill us with his spirit so that we can endure and to lean on him. So if you're listening today and you have a desire to know Jesus, you want to get to know Jesus, I want you to repeat these words with me as much as you can. Father, it is written in your word that if I confess with my mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in my heart that you have raised him from the dead, I shall be saved. Therefore, Father, I confess that Jesus is my Lord. I make him Lord of my life right now, today. I renounce my past life with Satan and close the door to all of his devices. I thank you, Lord, for forgiving me of all my sins. Jesus is my Lord, and I am a new creation. Old things have passed away. Now all things are new. In Jesus' name, amen. Wherever you live, listen, look for a local church that is streaming online and connect with that local church and allow yourself to be planted. I know many of us are live streaming right now, but you can still get planted. Listen, join the church online. Listen, there are ways you can join the church online. But I want to encourage you to get planted so that that ministry can nurture. The Bible says in 1 John chapter 5, verses 4 and 5, for every child of God defeats this evil world. We achieve this victory through our faith. And who can win this battle against the world? Only those who believe that Jesus is the Son of God. If you believe that, ladies and gentlemen, you already win, and you can declare, I am victorious. That's all we have time for today. Tomorrow morning, we're going to be moving on in Revelation chapter 2 and talking about the church at Pergamos. Read ahead of me if you like, but join us again tomorrow morning, live at 5. Those on the call, please remain on the line. God bless you.
And friends, for the last hour, you have been listening to Command Your Morning Prayer Line, live from Near Prune Ministries Incorporated, 702 Ossie Davis Parkway, out of Waycross, Georgia. Where the pastor is Pastor Samuel Sellers III, the host of Command Your Mornings, Evangelist Dr. Renee Sellers. Don't forget, it comes your way now, Monday through Friday. And that's 5 a.m. until 6 a.m. on a recorded portion of the program in its entirety, 11 p.m. until 8 p.m. on the Glory Bound Train. Listen online at www.foxy97.com. Command Your Morning is a service of the Approved Ministries Incorporated, 702 R.C. Davis Parkway, Waycross, Georgia.
Your name.